I was told I was found inside a pile of Calabao crap. Or maybe a pile of garbage. Parents back then told their children that story all the time. Why? I do not know. Maybe they thought it was funny. Well, I tell the same stories to my kids sometimes. And yeah, I think it's funny. I thought by now there'd be flying cars. I remember when I was a little boy and talking to my niece, the one that's only a year younger than me, we talked about the year 2000, about flying cars, robots that can walk and talk like us, and traveling through space, and how old we would be. Back then, 34 and 33, seemed really old. Well, we got the ages right. But whatever happened to the flying cars? No flying cars? Oh well. Philippines when I was 2 or 3 years old and moved to the States. We ended up in downtown San Francisco. We lived on a street called Natomao. Not too sure about the address, but I remember that house. It was way fun. We played up and down stairs, we played in the hallway, we played on the streets. My sister even poked my brother Dario's eye with an umbrella. Yeah, that was fun. The family was growing. Yeah, more kids to play with. Now those were the days.
Never before and never since I've
The oldest daughter in the family had her firstborn, and it was a big deal. It was an exciting time. To me, it was just another playmate. And boy, do I remember torturing my nephews. Way fun. I was only a child myself. Children can be so cruel. I was the mean uncle for a long time. But time, it changes all of us.
I'm 15 for a moment, caught in between 10 and 20, and I'm just dreaming, counting the ways to where you are. I'm 22 for a moment, and she feels better than ever, and we're on fire, making our way back from Mars. 15, there's still time for you, time to buy and time to lose. 15, there's never a wish better than this, when you only got 100 years to live.
Growing up with such a big family was crazy. Half of these people I didn't even know were related to me. Everybody was either kuya or ate. For you who don't understand, kuya and ate means brother and sister. Can you imagine if we never left the Philippines? Well, I can't. This was, after all, our home. And it was sweet.
Imagine there's no heaven. See you there.
Sorry for the interruption, but do you remember when I said I didn't even know that half of these people were related to me? Well, you see, this guy, Piattoni, I thought he was really Elvis Presley. Can you imagine that? I was related to the king. Maybe that's why I got into music.
Stay here in heaven. on the door. There's peace, I'm sure, and I know there'll be no more tears in heaven. Would you know?
A little after our father died, we moved 23rd Street. I remember that bright yellow building in the backyard with weeds and concrete. It was a two-story flat. My oldest sister lived on the very top, and her mom and the rest of the children lived in the first floor. Behind the garage was another living area. My brother David lived there for a while, and Walter built himself a little room under the garage stairs. That was hella cool. We had some of the most valuable stuff when I was a kid. The lampshades. Valuable lampshades. They were covered with clear plastic, and so were part of the hallways. Other people's homes, they had couches that were valuable. They had those covered with plastics as well. The piano wasn't covered with plastic, so naturally we figured it wasn't very valuable. Cookies and potato chips found its way in between the keys, and it finally went out of tune. We had a giant wooden spoon and fork on our wall, right next to a giant burgundy freezer. Yes, we were giants. We were a giant family. Thanksgiving was there every year, and also Christmas and New Year's. Sometimes I get this feeling that I wish I was back in the old days.
Sometimes I get the feeling I was back in the old days. When we were kids, when we were young, things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young. The sun was always shining, we just lived for fun. Sometimes it seems like lately, I just don't know. The rest of my life's been just a show.
Thank you.
My mom used to make me and my brother Dario wear the same type of clothes for parties. They did the same thing to my sister Mary Jane and our niece Radina. And I was just crazy. What were they thinking? Just Dario just blocked that fact out by simply staring into the camera. He was in so much shock, I guess. My nephew Eric, he'd cry during parties most of the time because he needed to blow out the candles. I was always getting into trouble. Not only did my mom have to raise her own children, she also helped with raising her grandchildren. The house was always filled with kids. I don't think there was a time where there was no babies in our family. There was always someone to play with. Whoa! What was that? Dario with an action shot. Definitely have to see that again. Rewind.
Belly face down on the mattress one. And you hold me, and we are broken.
Yeah.
We spent a lot of our time at San Bruno. It was like a second home to us. I remember the mean old man a few houses down. We would tease that guy every time we rode our bikes past his house. I don't think he was really all that mean. We were just cruel. Queer's house was on a hill, so naturally, us kids rode everything down that thing. Bikes, trikes, wagons, skates, skateboards, you name it, we crashed it.
Like my father's come to pass, 7 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September ends. Here comes the rain again, falling from the stars, drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are. As my memory rests, but never forgets what I lost, wake me up when September ends. We'll be right back. The innocent can never.
It's been over 10 years since we lost our Inamo, but not a day goes by without her spirit touching us one way or another, either by a memory, a sound, or a smell, and through her life, we remember her strength. This was my point of view of my family's past. I'm sure you all have your own versions, but one thing stays the same. We look into the future and we expect many wonderful things. Well, I expected flying cars. But where are the flying cars? I don't ask that question anymore. It's not that important. The future gave me something more than I expected, but I had to look into the past to obtain it. The lessons learned in my past gave me my future, my family.